Welcome to this week's webisode of The Better Half. I'm Kendra D. St. Aubin. This is Katie Hartley, and we're going to take a look back at what's been going on this week.
Well, this week, last weekend, was the opening weekend for the Diamondbacks at Chase Field. I was there. You were there. What a great time. That's one of the pictures I took. I was sitting out in right field. Had a great time this weekend. There's me and my Cold Stone.
Nice.
But, Kendra, you were in the press box, right?
I was, but did you see the picture of Bernsey and I sharing Cold Stone ice cream?
I didn't see it.
Yes, in the press box, Bernsey and I went downstairs, we got Cold Stone, and we shared it out of the same bowl, and we did take some heat for that.
Aww.
But that's all right. It was awesome. It was a great weekend. It always makes it easier when the team wins, I think, for all of us involved in the media, which is a huge part of it. So I think basically what it proved to me is that I think they're legitimately going to be as good as all the hype. I think they're going to live up to it. And what's great is that they're not arrogant about it. I don't think they feel they're coming into the season after last season like with a bunch of, it's a quiet swagger, you know what I mean? Like they have confidence, but they're not obnoxious.
Well, and they look good. I mean, we saw all different sides of the Diamondbacks too this past weekend. You know, on Saturday night we saw them rally back to beat the Giants. This team is so much fun to watch. I realize, and I do this every year, I realize how much I miss baseball.
Absolutely.
When it comes back.
Yes.
I forget how much fun it is. J.J. Putz is one of my favorite guys to watch pitch. I can't wait to see what him and the rest of the team do. I know I finished my entire ice cream, though, by myself.
Nice. It'll be a great year, though. I mean, if you're going to play 162 games, it helps when the team is winning. So.
Well, one guy who's not off to a good start this year is Ozzie Guillen, the manager for the Miami Marlins. Still got to get used to that, Miami Marlins. Suspended for 5 games for his comments about saying that he loved Fidel Castro. He's now coming back and saying that it was the biggest mistake of his life. He's very sorry for his comments. Kendra, what do you think? Do you think 5 games is enough?
Well, first of all, I do think 5 games is enough because if you were going to go longer than that, I think they should have just fired him. Because I know a lot of people are saying it wasn't enough, but I think either 5 games or you just let the guy go. I mean, you can't just drag it out forever, you know, into the middle of the season. I think it's interesting that two things. A, he's blaming the translation, you know, kind of a language barrier with how the question was asked and what he answered and how it translates into Spanish. And secondly, why all of a sudden is he apologizing for these comments? Because how many times in the past has he made derogatory comments and statements about people and groups of people? And he has never apologized. Pedro Gomez said that yesterday. He has never apologized in 15 years of knowing him for anything he's ever said and done. So it's interesting now, you know, maybe, as you said, they threatened him with the job and then he apologized.
And that's what kind of ticks me off about this situation is I don't think that he's sorry and I don't think that he feels bad about what he said. I think that he could actually care less. And that's what makes me the most angry is I think that that organization came in and said, listen, we need you to go out there and apologize because we still have to put butts in the seats this year and we need you here to do it. And that makes me so angry that this guy can get away with saying something like that after what he's done in the past to other people. You know, a few years ago, he called Jay Mariotti a fag and didn't apologize for that. He's spoken out about illegal immigration and Asian versus Latino athletes. I mean, it's like this guy has a bad track record and we're still gonna let him go on and just say whatever he wants and slap his hand and go, well, don't do it again, but we know he's going to.
And not that it's an excuse, but honestly, I think he's just kind of an idiot. I really think he just says, he clearly says things without thinking and just feels like he can get away with it, unfortunately.
Yeah, it's sad. Sad story. Not a sad story. The Coyotes, though, in the playoffs, very exciting. They won their first ever division title. So excited to see these guys in the playoffs. Kendra, what is your favorite part about the whiteout?
Well, as you can see from the picture there, I think what's amazing about the whiteout is that it's a sold-out arena. I mean, the crowd is just electric. So regardless of what color t-shirt people are wearing, and this time they're playing the Blackhawks, the past two seasons it was the Red Wings, so you know that their fans travel well. We have a lot of transplants here. And I don't think the Coyotes even care who they're playing in front of it. As long as it's sold out and there's so much energy in that building, I think it's going to be a great playoff series. And they really lucked out having the Thursday-Saturday games with the other teams out of town, the Diamondbacks and the Suns being out of town, so that also helps them.
Yeah, a lot of focus on them. My favorite part of the Coyotes being in the playoffs is the playoff beards.
Oh, yes.
Nothing wrong with a guy with a little facial scruff.
And our very own Carter Nacki is sporting the playoff beard.
You can donate
for, you know, charity for that as well. So
he is.
I don't know who else around the office is doing it. We'll have to take a little tally and find out.
I just hope the Coyotes keep winning so that the guys could rock the beards.
It'll be
nice. I'm a big fan. I'm not a big fan of Bobby Petrino, though. What a freaking train wreck this guy is. He has officially been fired as the head coach.
I love that picture.
At Arkansas. It's
awesome. When I first saw that, I thought it was a joke.
So he, of course, was involved in a motorcycle accident. And it has now come out that the woman that was on the back of the motorcycle, Jessica Durrell, was his mistress.
He was 25 years old.
He was trying to claim that it was an inappropriate relationship from the past and this and that. I, for one, have never traveled in a car with my ex-boyfriends, like, even anywhere. It's just so ridiculous.
Hello, he's 50-whatever years old. Who cares? And he's an employer of the, you know, university. He's employed by the state. I mean, it is sickening on so many levels. And she's 25 and beautiful and engaged. I mean, what is she thinking? I mean, we all know these guys are complete idiots and total, you know, DBs, as we talked about before. But, I mean, the girls in these situations, what are they thinking?
Do you think they're equally to blame? I mean, do you think it's equally the man's fault as it is the woman's fault in this case?
Well, I think the problem is when you're a person of authority or you're her employer, you're working for a university, you're her boss, you know, technically there is more onus on you as the adult, you know, to make a better decision. But at the same time, I just do not understand what the heck these women are doing. It seriously makes me want to vomit.
I don't understand how neither one of them, did you really think you weren't going to get caught?
That's what they all think. That's how it all works.
It's crazy.
Yes, it's a power trip. It's a power trip by the men, and I don't know what the girls are thinking to go along with it. It's just,
and her
boyfriend
fired,
is
too.
Cute. I mean, he's
really cute.
Notice we haven't seen him at all. I mean, if I was him, well, I'd stay far, far away from that and get out of that.
He's actually the director of swimming and diving operations at the university.
Which is kind of weird that he's also an employee of the university.
It is. Well, the whole thing is a little bit weird. I feel bad for him. They were scheduled to be married on June 9th, actually, of this year.
I hope he backs. And then there was a story that he gave her $20,000.
Yeah.
I don't know if that was before or after or whatever. And then there were reports that maybe there's some great pictures of him on his cell phone that was given to him by the state. Just not a good
situation. Two thumbs down for both of them. Shame on both of you.
Good for you, Arkansas, for getting rid of him.
Yeah.
I'm all for that.
But they were talking about maybe not firing him if he took the penalties.
Yeah, if he took the penalties. But the fact, I love that they didn't give it all.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. All right, Kendra, we are out of time.
Now I'm fired up.
You can follow her on Twitter. Get more of Kendra's rage on Twitter, at Kendra620. You can follow me at FunKatie620, and we'll see you next week for another webisode of The Better Half.